for discussion. Maybe we'll read Maharishi's like thought for the day from Maharishi's book. We'll read. Please read. Noble thought, thought, word, and deed. The wave emanating from man, whether it is smell, sight, word, or thought, whatever it be, the wave would carry all his qualities as every man acts on his past experience imprints. His thought, word, and deed would be based on his own imprints. All his qualities would be emanated through the wave. Every man has good and bad imprints inherent in him. Hence, based on the mind, the thought arising may be righteous or conflicting. Here, righteous or conflicting thoughts are not based on the thing or person it is reaching. It is based on the person from whom it is generated. Without knowing this science, this philosophy, we have created innumerable imprints in us and allowed to root inside us. When we encourage unnecessary bad imprints, it gets registered deep and controls our qualities as bad thoughts. It is great spiritual exercise to weed out bad imprints by changing unrighteous and conflicting thoughts. We should practice to generate good, pleasant waves by pure thought, words, and deeds. Only here we can understand the benefits of blessing someone. Be blessed by the divine. Aspirants, you can share your views regarding this thought for the day.
Nice noble thought, Amma. So we have told about the imprints which are registered in the genetic center, which way it comes through thought, word, and deed. This should have be this can be known by we can do by introspection and then a meditation to eradicate the imprints, which that is bad imprints. Or we have to live in awareness and keeping the law of nature. We know the law of nature, that is selakeetha vilaivu, and whatever you do through thought, word, and deed, that should be in awareness. If you follow these awareness and know the principle of law of nature, usually we don't do the bad prints in this generation and do the good prints by and then bad prints which are brought about by our forefathers and ancestors can be nullified by introspection or dhavam or by doing service to the society. This is my understanding, Amma.
Be blessed by the divine, Amma. Thank you, Amma. It's very nice sharing, Amma.
Thank you.
Be blessed by the divine. Ayya, do you want to share your view, Ayya? Sivakumar, Ayya?
Amma, she covered already. Next time I'll share, Amma. Vahalamudan.
Sure, Ayya. Vahalamudan. Amma, Mahadevi Amma, do you want to share something, Amma? Be blessed by the divine. We can conclude, I think, by singing the world blessings. Let us conclude this session with blessings for the world. The rain may pour on all parts of the world timely and sufficiently. Food grains may grow abundantly to the satisfaction of all living beings. The leaders of all nations may progress in spiritual knowledge and do good services to humanity. The whole world may enjoy prosperity, happiness, and peace. The whole world may enjoy prosperity, happiness, and peace. The whole world may enjoy prosperity, happiness, and peace. Be blessed by the divine. Let us bless all the participants, those who sing the God salutations, Guru salutations, and blessings for the world. By the grace of the divine power, all of their family may enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, prosperity, wisdom, and peace. With this, we conclude today's session by the grace of God and our Guru. Thank you all for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Be blessed by the divine. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.
Thank you, Mom. Be blessed by the divine.
Thank you, Mom.